everyone. My name is Gary. I'm a second year student respiratory therapist, and welcome to my channel. As you guys can tell from the title, this is a Q&A, so I'm going to answer all of your questions and hopefully give you some tips and some helpfulness for being in the program or trying to get into the program or whatever you guys have for me. So let's go. Well, first of all, I would like to apologize for the bad quality that this is gonna upload in. It says it's HD, but I know it's not gonna be. I don't post a lot of YouTube videos, but when I do, it's always like film for my iPhone, bad quality, the upload is weird. I apologize. First question is, what made you want to be an RT? Okay, being an RT was not my first choice. And I think I've been pretty vocal about that. I always wanted to be an actor, so I pursued acting, and then after a couple years of acting, I was like, I should probably go back to school just in case. And so when I went to school, I was a film major because I did TV and video production in high school. And yeah, I just love editing, I love filming, I love making a movie, so I thought this is perfect for me. But in college, it was not as exciting. It was going back to the basics. I already knew all this stuff. I was getting A's in all my classes, but the excitement wasn't there anymore. The thrill for me wasn't there. There was no challenge, and I just really wanted to change that. Anyway, so that's when I decided maybe I should change my major. I've always been interested in the medical field, but I obviously don't want to go to school for 2,000 years and become a doctor. And the duties of a nurse did not appeal to me. So I was like, wait, like my grandma's a respiratory therapist. Why did I never think of this before? And I used to like go to work with her, and I know like she was a supervisor, so it was okay. But yeah, so I used to go with her all the time, and I was really familiar with being in a hospital. I was never one of those people who didn't like going to the doctors or didn't like going to a hospital. Like, it actually intrigued me. And so I started looking up, like, what does an RT do? I started YouTubing. As we all know, there's not that much out there, which is one of the reasons why I started this channel. But yeah, so I was just Googling a lot of things and getting more information. And I was like, I think I totally want to do this. So I switched colleges that had a respiratory degree, and I started pursuing the medical field and took all these preclinical sciences. And let me tell you, if you are in the preclinical phase, yes, it is going to feel like forever until you can finish all of your preclinicals. Just do it, and next thing you know, you're in the program. Like, I'm already halfway through my program and I'm like, wait, what? Where did this come from? I remember I still had to do like this math and anatomy and all that stuff, and it just flies by. So don't think about how long it's gonna take. Like, a year goes by so fast. You got this, stick to it. Okay, that was a really long answer to the first question, but basically my grandma's a respiratory therapist. I've always liked the idea of working in the medical field, so I thought I would pursue it, and here I am. Okay, next question. So what's the difference between working in a hospital in real life versus working in a hospital on TV? So I've worked on a lot of TV shows and movies. You guys may not know that, but yeah. It's definitely different. But like, comparing it to, let's compare it to Grey's Anatomy. Of all the medical shows that I've watched, Grey's Anatomy has to be the most accurate. I know a lot of medical shows have their own doctor or nurse or like medical person who's in charge of making sure that it's like legit sounding and looking and everything. But like, I've seen The Resident, I've seen Code Black, I've seen The Night Shift, like, all those, I'm like, these do not compare to Grey's. Grey's is just, yeah, I don't know, even after, like, going and working at the hospital for my past two clinicals, like, I'm like, okay, Grays is really legit. Like, they have this setup, they have that in the background. Like, every little thing is like, Grey's Anatomy, you're doing good, okay? Maybe that's why they have like 15 seasons, right? But yeah, it's definitely different in a sense of like, when you're there in the hospital, you're like, okay, wow, like, this is real life. This is not TV. This is somebody's life. Like, it's very fast paced. It's like such organized chaos. It's really sad and beautiful just to have everybody working together just to save somebody. But yeah, they're definitely different. Okay, next question. What should I bring to clinicals as a first-year student respiratory therapist? I've done a post on my Instagram saying like my top things to bring to clinical. So definitely check that out because I might leave something out. But for sure a pen, maybe two if you are susceptible to losing pens. Have a little notebook. If you guys watch Grey's Anatomy, you see like the interns running around, like following the residents, like writing things down. It's exactly how your first day is gonna be at the hospital. You're writing things down on where, like what floor is what, like floor six is neuro, fourth is this, fifth is peds, like, you know, like you're not gonna remember all that. So you're like writing everything down, jotting it down. Like they might give you a code to like a door. You're not gonna remember that, write it down. There's just a lot of little things that you're gonna write down. If you know you're following your preceptor and they say like, oh, well this breath sound, it kind of sounds like blah, blah, blah. You want to remember that ronchi is gonna be like a gurgling sound. You know what I mean? Because at your next patient, you're gonna be like, my preceptor said that the gurgling was, what was it? Was it wheezes? Was it, you know? And it's just very handy to have a little notebook. And what I did was I would write all my vitals down in it, because like after a while you're gonna be like, I know pH, I know PCO2, like all that stuff, but in the moment you might not remember, and you can just have this little like cheat sheet in the back of your notebook to help you out with, like, what's acidosis and all that stuff. So yeah, definitely a notebook, a pen. Scissors have saved me before. But a lot of times in patient rooms, depending on the hospital, like there's scissors on the cart. Little tip that I do is when you're at the hospital, it could be at the cart in a patient's room or it can be in the medication room, but there are alcohol pads. I always take a little stack, put it in my pocket, and after every patient, I wipe my stethoscope because cleanliness for the patient and because it's around my neck, I'm just at the hospital, I'm always washing my hands, I'm always like sanitizing everything, my pens, so that's just me. I definitely recommend compression socks. You're going to be on your feet for 13 hours, you need compression socks. It helps with blood circulation, it helps, like, it just doesn't give you this fatigue that you have without them. And I highly recommend, I did not have them my first rotation. Let me tell you, my feet were killing me every day. Definitely now with compression socks, it's so much better. Definitely get comfortable shoes. Definitely stethoscope, pen, little notebook. I always have chapstick on me. Bring your phone charger with you because you're there for a long time. Have a lot of snacks. Like, I get so hungry in the hospital, like every 4 hours, I'm like, I need to eat. And I think it's because you're moving around so much. And if you stand a lot at your job now, like working on set, we're on set sometimes for 16 hours. Like, I'm used to long days. I'm used to staying on my feet for 6 hours in a row. Like, but at the hospital, it's just different. Like, you're on your feet, you're going up and down this patient to that patient, you're bending over, like, here's the bed, you know, like you're constantly bending over. A tip, you know, raise the bed up, save your back. You're gonna be doing this for a long time. So you'll find little things to help alleviate pain. Okay, next question. Did you always know you wanted to work in a hospital? So I guess this was kind of answered with what made you want to be an RT. No, I did not always know I wanted to work in a hospital. It was kind of like an epiphany where after researching it and thinking about it, I was like, why didn't I think of this before? Like I said, my grandma was an RT, like, ever since I was a little kid. I never thought, like, ooh, I want to be an RT. it never like crossed my mind, to be honest. And now that I'm doing it, it's like, I'm doing this? Wait, who put me in charge of saving someone's life? Like, you're gonna go through these moments of self-doubt. You're gonna go through these like anxious moments. You're gonna question everything. And that's perfectly okay, and that's perfectly normal, and you're gonna realize how much you love it or how much you hate it. And if you hate it, if you don't like it, it's okay not to like it. You know, don't force yourself to do something you don't wanna do. But if you're curious, and if you wanna know more, and if you wanna save people's lives, if you want a job that's rewarding, a job that pays well, then this is something for you. And, you know, not everybody was built to be a nurse or an RT or a doctor. And all those people who are in the medical field, they worked to be in that position. And yes, they seem so smart and they seem so like comfortable and confident, but that comes over time. Everybody was anxious, everybody was worried, everybody was stressed. So don't let that get to you and don't let that discourage you, because if you set your mind to it, you can do it. So just believe in yourself. So someone asked, what school do you attend, community college / university? So this is one thing that I have decided to keep quiet on, what school I go to. I know a lot of people share what school they go to. That's not something I feel comfortable in doing, and I've just had a lot of bad experiences with like stalkers. So to have a public account talking about my journey in the medical field, it took me a lot to get to that point of where I wanted to do it. So definitely one thing that I'm not gonna do is name my school, unfortunately. But that is definitely something that I have decided I do want to do once I graduate. And it's just kind of like, I would prefer not to be like leaving class and looking over my shoulder to see if people are following me or something. But I mean, I do live in LA. There are not that many schools that have a respiratory therapy program. So you can Google around LA and see all the schools, and maybe I go to that one. Maybe I don't, but yeah. It's a 2 year or like a year and a half program. It's not accelerated, but we do go to all the best hospitals here around LA. So like Cedars-Sinai, UCLA, definitely recommend looking into which school you want to go to and which hospitals they work with, because I know some people in an RT program or even a nursing program, and they just go to like skilled facilities or really small community hospitals, and you really want to get that really great experience in your internships, because it sets you up for a possible career. If you want to work in a skilled like facility, if you want to work in home care, if you want to do a really small community hospital, then that's great. But if you want to go to those major hospitals, your school can really give you an advantage, because you do know the directors, you do know the supervisors, you have worked with the RTs, and it's just gonna help you during the hiring process. So it's kind of all up to you. But I really like the hospitals we go to. Okay, next question. My hair is just so crazy. So I was like growing my hair out, and then I got discouraged and I cut it, and now I regret it because I'm growing it out once again. So it's just all these awkward phases. But what's really cool is like at UCLA, for example, people have dyed hair, like guys have long hair, guys have man buns, everyone has like, not everyone, but a lot of people have tattoos, and so they're just like really open and diverse, so it's pretty cool. So don't worry about like your hair and trying to look all professional and clean cut it, like do you, as long as you're good at your job, it doesn't matter, you know? Okay, next question. Sorry, I feel like this is taking a long time. How stressful is it being an RT, and does it ever get overwhelming? Yes, it's pretty stressful, but not at the same time. I think the most overwhelming part is doing school and working at the hospital, because you are going to have multiple classes, you are going to have quizzes and tests and you're gonna have to go to the hospital 2 times that week. You know, so it's like, when are you supposed to sleep and when are you supposed to study? I don't know. But yeah, I think school and working as an RT is stressful. Being an RT alone, I don't think it's that stressful. As a student, you really do have your preceptor to like ride off of. You don't like set the whole time management aspect of it. Like you're kind of just doing what they're telling you to do. And yeah, a lot of times they're gonna like let you do your own thing or ask you like, what should we do? How should we do this? Which is great, but for the most part, you're just kind of following them and like, they're gonna tell you to do this medication at this time and when you're gonna go back and see this patient. And I feel like that's one of my weaknesses is just, how am I gonna get to this point of knowing who to see when? Like, you know, like you're gonna have 4 patients, they're all Q4, which means you're gonna give them their medication every 4 hours. So that starts at 8 a.m. How do you know which one to go to first? You know, that's what I have to work on, and I think that's what comes with time as a student and working in the field. Like everyone, like preceptors, they say like, you're not gonna know this off the bat. You know, it's gonna take time to get in a groove of things. And so I think that's like a portion of being a student where it's a little easier is you're following their like schedule in their head. Like they know what to do, when to do it, and you're just doing it with them, if that makes sense. It can be pretty stressful in like emergency situations or like extubations or intubations. Like you always have to be prepared for like, what if it goes downhill, you know? You always have your preceptor there, so not too stressful. What do you enjoy most about this field? One of the things that I say I like most about being a respiratory therapist is that it is a specialized career. You are dealing with the pulmonary system and its surrounding organs, and obviously you have to know, you know, things about everything kind of, but it's very specialized. Like you're in charge of the airway, you know breath sounds like the back of your hand, you know, like you know what to do in emergency situations, what device to use, when to use it. And it's really nice to feel like relied on for certain aspects of patient care. And it's a really rewarding career because like you're saving people's lives, you're helping people get better. You have to remember that giving the medications and the treatments, it's for a purpose. And to be able to go home and know that like you made someone feel better, or that like you took a tube out of them, or that you helped save somebody's life, you know, like you did CPR and they survived, like whatever it may be, it's rewarding no matter which way you put it. Okay, so one last question is, do you always have another RT student with you as a partner, or are you alone most of the time during treatments and code blues? Okay, so it's kind of a few questions in one, but during code blues, you are not alone. Usually multiple people get paged, whether it is to a pager or some sort of walkie-talkie system like Vocera, or if it's over the intercom. By the time you get to the code, if you're not the first one, if you're not already in the room, there's going to be people in there. There might be another RT in there. There might be, well, there's definitely going to be nurses. There might already be a doctor. There might be resident students in there. You're definitely not alone. As in terms of, are you with another RT student throughout the day? No. You have your own preceptor. Let's say there's 4 of you. 4 of you at this hospital, you're all gonna get assigned 4 different preceptors, and you all are gonna go to your own floor, have your own patients. Do you see them? Yes, you do see them throughout the day, even at such a big hospital like UCLA. A lot of times we got our lunch together, you see them like when your professor comes to talk about things, see how you're doing. You see them during like maybe the program, maybe the director of the RT department wants to talk to you or teach you something, you're definitely gonna see them. You're not really hanging out with them. Kind of depends on the hospital or the preceptor. Like sometimes you'll go do things together, like you go down to the department and get supplies, or for example, one preceptor had me and another student go give a treatment to a patient. So it was just us in the room, and the preceptor was like outside the room. And like one of us did the vitals, one of us did the breath sounds, one of us did the breathing treatment, and yeah, so just stuff like that. So for the most part, it's just you and your preceptor, but there are times when you're with other students, so it's fun. Okay guys, well that is all the questions I have. This is my very first Q&A. It was a lot of fun and I hope you guys learned something new. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. Leave a comment down below if you have any more questions, if I didn't answer your question, or yeah. Also don't forget to follow me on Instagram, instagram.com/GaryGarryRT.